Let's move to India. Jammu and Kashmir, which remains a victim of Pakistan-sponsored terrorism. Out of frustration, Pakistan-backed terrorists in the valley are killing innocent civilians and security personnel to create unrest in Jammu and Kashmir. To demoralize the force, unarmed policemen are also being targeted in the region. We have a report. The militancy in Kashmir is witnessing a shift in pattern. Jammu and Kashmir police and civilians have emerged as the prime targets. Official data from 2021 show that for the first time in a year, the number of police personnel killed by terrorists has outnumbered the collective toll of other security personnel who were targeted in the valley. Recently, again, a policeman and a civilian were targeted in two different incidents. In the first, terrorists fired at a property dealer Rauf Ahmed Khan in Srinagar's Eidgah. Within 30 minutes of the first attack, another terror strike took place in Bijbejara area. An assistant police sub-inspector, Mohammad Ashraf, shot and rushed to a nearby hospital. Both the victims were later declared dead at the hospitals they were receiving treatment in. The Inter-Services Intelligence designated the Resistance Front has taken responsibility for both the terror attacks. This terror outfit has come to light recently after it took responsibility for the multiple killings of civilians of minority communities in the valley.
So what is happening in the Kashmir Valley is that after Operation All Out and then the abrogation of Article 370 in 2019, and making of the two union territories out of the state, the law and order situation is now fully under control. The total number of militants that have been killed right from the top, and all their ID experts and the other experts who were in recruitment experts and also their commanders, is more than 200. Now this has created a big vacuum and has all nearly demolished the entire militancy terrorism network over there. This has disturbed Pakistan very much. And Pakistan is now using its proxies of the underground overground workers and has directed them to make these random killings, whether it's of civilians or it's of policemen or anyone, whosoever is there, so that it sends a message across to the people there that, look, terrorism is still alive.
The incidents of targeting civilians in Kashmir are barbaric. Innocent people who are working for society and have nothing to do with anyone are being targeted. This is an attempt to create an atmosphere of fear and to give it a communal color so as to damage the communal harmony in Kashmir. Terrorists belonging to the outfits like the Resistance Front are acting on the directions of the agencies across the border in Pakistan so that Kashmir is kept disturbed and hurdles are put in the way of peace in valley.
Pakistan is totally in a morass of terrorism, militancy and also gun culture. If you see in Pakistan, there is law and order is not there. The people are dying of hunger and the Pakistani government is running with a begging bowl all over. The only problem with Pakistan is that America, somehow or the other, it still does not want to abandon it because of its own problems. And that is the reason why it keeps defending Pakistan in most of the forums.
Since the abrogation of Article 370, Indian security forces have managed to foil all the devious agendas of Pakistan and maintain peace in the valley. This is the reason behind the disappointment of the Pakistani establishment and Pakistan-sponsored terrorists in the valley. The recent brutal killings of innocent civilians and security personnel in Kashmir reflect the frustration among the terrorists and their mentors across the border. However, such barbaric terror acts will not succeed in undermining Jammu and Kashmir's development journey, as people in Kashmir will not let this conspiracy succeed.